ice. It's great for our drinks and can be fun to slide on. Historically, though, it's proven to not be so great a thing to take naps under. Yet in 2016, one man was buried under ice for several hours, and despite what you might expect, he came back to life when resuscitated. Yet how did this lucky man manage to do the impossible? It was a blustery winter morning in Pennsylvania when Don Smith spotted his son's boot sticking out from under a snowdrift on the side of the road. Screeching his car to a halt, he rushed out into the snow and started digging his son out of the snowdrift under which he was almost completely buried. To Smith's horror, his son's face was blue and he could feel no pulse or heartbeat. In a panic, he called 911, and as emergency responders braved the icy roads, he silently prepared himself for the worst. His son had been lying under a snowdrift for 12 hours in -4 degree Fahrenheit weather. How could there be any chance he would survive? Smith was flown via a helicopter to a nearby hospital, where a team of doctors and nurses warmed up his body and attempted unsuccessfully to restart his heart with CPR. The paramedics were unable to find any signs of life in Justin Smith's body, and one even draped a sheet over what was presumed to be a corpse. Yet, as the coroner was called and the police began their investigation into the exact circumstances surrounding his death, emergency department physician Gerald Coleman ordered a potassium test of Smith's blood, as high levels of potassium in the blood indicates that heart muscle activity is either significantly reduced or has completely stopped. However, to the surprise of everyone, the test results came back normal, giving the hospital staff hope that the heart could in fact be restarted. Using a technique called extracorporeal membrane oxygenation, the doctors began to pump warm oxygenated blood into Smith's heart and then throughout his body. Incredibly, the heart began to slowly quiver, and using shock paddles, the doctors managed to shock the heart into restarting completely. Smith was then hooked up to ventilators, which would breathe for him, and warm oxygenated blood continued to be pumped through his thawing body. Despite the miracle of restarting Smith's frozen heart, doctors feared that he would in effect be brain dead after an incredible 12 hours of lying frozen under a snowdrift. Against all odds, scans began to pick up electrical signals given off by neurological activity, and as the signals increased, it would become clear that Smith was experiencing completely normal brain activity. Though he would lose his toes and little fingers to frostbite, Smith would eventually wake up from his coma and make a complete recovery. As incredible as it may seem, freezing might have actually saved Smith's life. When the body is frozen at the right rate, the slowing metabolic processes will actually protect the body from the effects of exposure. Cooling cells slows down their metabolic activity, and they don't require as much oxygen to function anymore. And as the heart slows and breathing stops, the body enters a state of suspended animation. The key to Smith's survival was that his heart had kept very slowly beating for hours after his burial in ice, and doctors managed to begin CPR on him not too long after it stopped beating. The still oxygenated blood in his system helped keep his organs alive, thanks to their vastly reduced metabolic activity. Not at all dissimilar to the way that hibernating animals can dramatically reduce both their heartbeats and their breathing rate and still remain alive. Smith's miraculous recovery has encouraged modern medicine to consider that there's no temperature too low to try to resuscitate someone, and his story is mirrored throughout history, with a little girl in 1994 being brought back to life after freezing solid. One winter morning, 5-year-old Carly Kosolowski woke up to her father saying goodbye as he prepared to go to work. He tucked Carly in bed with her mother and promptly left. Unbeknownst to her father, though, Carly had gotten up and tried to follow her dad outside, leaving the house dressed in nothing more than her pajamas. Once outside, the door closed behind her, and she realized she was too short to reach the outside door handle. For 5 hours, little Carly lay against the front door of her house in below-zero winter weather, discovered by her mother frozen stiff. Her mother, who had been trained in CPR, immediately began to try and resuscitate her but was unable to. Carly was rushed to the hospital where doctors would successfully warm up her body and bring her back to life. Incredibly, Carly also suffered no brain damage despite her prolonged ordeal, and the only major injury was the amputation of the lower part of her left leg due to frostbite. In 1980, 19-year-old Jean Hillard was driving home in her hometown of Langby, Minnesota, on a night with -22 degree weather. Suddenly, her truck hit a patch of ice and the brakes locked, sending her into a ditch. Living in a rather rural area, Jean began to walk to try to find help, wearing only a jacket, jeans, and cowboy boots. One of her best friends lived only 2 miles down the road, and Jean was confident she could make the walk. As she walked along the icy road, though, she began to feel lethargic and confused, early signs of hypothermia. And then, when she finally saw the lights of her friend's home, Jean collapsed and blacked out. The next morning, her friend woke up and discovered a large lump in the snow just 15 feet from his door, and investigating, he was horrified to discover that it was Jean. Rushed to the hospital, the medical staff was pessimistic about Jean's chances of survival. Her body was frozen so stiff that they were unable to pierce her flesh with the hypodermic needle. The needle simply snapped off on contact with her frozen solid body. Her body temperature was so low that it didn't register on a thermometer, and her face was ashen gray in color. Deciding that she was dead, the staff still tried to warm up her body with the heating pads, and when her body reached a temperature of 88 degrees, physicians were shocked to discover a faint pulse of 12 beats a minute. Then, the doctors heard a very faint whimper, and they knew Jean was alive. Incredibly, Jean would be up and talking normally just a few hours later, worried about what her dad might think of her wrecking his truck. Medical terminology has come a long way since 1980, and today, doctors have found that half of hypothermia patients who are treated with extracorporeal membrane oxygenation, the process of pumping warmed blood into the heart and body that saved Justin Smith's life, all make a recovery, even if they've been in cardiac arrest for an extended period of time. Shockingly, if the patients had actually become hypothermic before their oxygen levels dropped too low, doctors believe that they could have escaped the worst of the long-term damage that comes from having your heart stop for long periods of time. Doctors are swiftly adopting new techniques that involve chilling patients who have suffered from extreme trauma, and at the University of Pittsburgh Medical Center, surgeons have been experimenting with pumping a cold saline solution into the arteries of patients suffering from gunshot and knife wounds in order to bring down the body's temperature. The emergency procedure would at one time have been considered practically murder, yet today doctors understand that gradually cooling the body slows down the metabolic process and can buy time for saving the life of someone who suffered major blood loss. The reduced need for oxygenated blood from chilled organs means that they can last longer without suffering damage that could prove to be fatal or lead to severely diminished function, especially in the brain. Yet, as revolutionary as these new procedures are, some doctors have long known the benefits of chilling a patient's body. Since the 1960s, surgeons in Siberia have been putting babies in snowbanks before major operations, and induced hypothermia has been useful for treating pediatric heart patients elsewhere for a long time. In most places, though, the procedure is a bit more refined than simply dumping a baby into a bunch of snow. But then again, as they are fond of saying in Russia, if it works, it works. The process of rapidly replacing a patient's blood with icy salt water, though, is relatively new and quite radical. Yet the technique seems to be working, and doctors refer to the procedure as suspending life. Wary of the science fiction implications of calling it suspended animation. The body seems to be incredibly resilient, and as medical technology advances, we are learning ever more incredible things about it. Sadly, though, thousands of people still freeze to death every year across America, and perhaps with more examples of these miraculous recoveries, doctors may learn more about what exactly happens to the body as it freezes, and how it may be brought back from what appears to be death. For the time being, though, we're going to go ahead and recommend that you don't make it a habit to take naps under large piles of snow. And if you get in a car accident in the middle of a blizzard, the best thing to do is to stay inside the cab of your vehicle and keep yourself warm. Wait for someone to come driving by. Or if you're in a really remote area, at least wait for the weather to clear a bit. How long do you think a person could stay frozen and come back to life? Let us know in the comments. And as always, if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more great content.